Let us study Kirchhoff's current law, which is abbreviated as Kcl also. About this, we can write that this law is about distribution of currents at a junction in the circuit, because we know well that overall charge in a system is always conserved. So there is a junction, and in this junction we can say at one side there is a wire which is connected to three other wires. And say a current I1 is coming onto the junction J. From this point the current is divided in three wires as I2, I3 and I4. Now in this situation we can state that as the total charge of the system is conserved, this I1 is divided in the three. So what amount of charge is flowing from this wire per unit time? The same is divided among these three wires. So we can write by conservation of charge I1 is equals to I2 plus I3 plus I4. Or we can also write it like I2 plus I3 plus I4 minus I1 is equals to 0. This equation states that at any junction the total sum of outgoing current in all the branches connected to the junction is equal to 0. It is basically just an alternative equation we have written for conservation of charge. And this is written as the equation of Kirchhoff's current law. We can say that this Kirchhoff's current law is nothing. It says that at a junction of a circuit, total sum of all outgoing currents in all branches at that junction is 0. The same we can write the total sum of all incoming currents in all branches at that junction is 0. That can also be written. That will be I1 minus I2 minus I3 minus I4 will be equal to 0. So we can write summation of II from I equals to 1 to n. If there are n branches coming at a particular junction, then the total current at the particular junction, if it is outgoing, then the sum of all these current will be 0. This is the equation for Kirchhoff's current law, and this is the statement for Kirchhoff's current law. Let's discuss an application of KCL. Or basically, here we are going to understand how we apply Kirchhoff's current law in a given circuit. So, we are given with a circuit of three resistances connected in this manner. Say the resistances are 3 ohm, 6 ohm and 4 ohm. And across the resistances, a battery of 20 volt is connected. Now here you can see, if we are required to find the current in different resistances, then we apply Kirchhoff's current law in this case, in which first we need to distribute the potential at various points of the circuit. Like if this battery is of 20 volt EMF, then we can consider on the negative side the potential is 0 volt, then with respect to this on the positive side potential will be 20 volt. Now, on this section of the circuit, potential will be 0. On this section, it will be 20. This is a junction where we consider the potential is x. If we know the value of potential x, we can directly calculate by using Ohm's law the current in all resistances. So, here we can see using Kirchhoff's current law for junction with potential x. In this situation, you can see from the battery a current I1 flows from the 4 ohm resistance, and finally a current I2 and I3 will be splitted from I1, and finally again the I1 current is combined. Now in this situation at the junction x, if we use Kirchhoff's current law, we can write sum of outgoing current is I2 plus I3 minus I1. So here we can write it as I2 plus I3 plus minus I1 is equal to 0. These three are the outgoing currents from the junction X and the sum of these currents must be 0. Now here potential we know it is 0, here it is X. So current through 3 ohm resistance can be written as potential difference upon resistance. So that will be X minus 0 by 3. So I2 we can write as X minus 0 by 3 plus similarly I3 current can be written as X minus 0 by 6 plus minus I1 is the current which is going out from junction X to the potential of 20 volts. So this current which is going out can be written as X minus 20 by 4. This should be equal to 0. However, we could also write here I1 is equals to 20 minus X by 4, but in that case there will be a negative sign which is 1 and same. Now in this situation we can take the LCM here to be equals to 12 and we just write the numerator of summation. This can be written as 4X plus 2X plus 3X minus 60 is equal to 0. Further simplifying, we are getting 4 plus 3, 7 plus 2, 9x is equals to 60. Then x will be 60 by 9. That can be written as 20 by 3 volt. So, the potential at the junction where we have taken it, the potential x, it is equal to 20 by 3 volt. So, now if we know the potential at this point, we can calculate all currents like current I2 we can write as X by 3. So, it will be 20 by 3 divided by 3. That will be 20 by 9 ampere. If we calculate the current in 6 ohm resistance, it will be X upon 6. That will be 20 by 3 upon 6. This is 20 by 18. That is 10 by 9 ampere. Similarly, we calculate I1. Thus, actually, I1 is flowing from 20 volt to X volt. So, it will be 20 minus X by 4. If we substitute the value of X to be 20 by 3, then 20 minus 20 by 3 will be 40 by 3. So, this will be 10 by 3 ampere. These are the currents flowing in the branches as well as if we know the potential X. From any two terminals of the circuit, we can directly get the potential difference as we know the potential at all points of the circuit. So, this is the way how we apply Kirchhoff's current law in a circuit. At any junction, if we don't know the potential, we write the Kcl equation. This is the Kcl equation for the junction where the potential is unknown. We solve it and get the value of potential at the junction where it is not directly known.